Welcome back to LTR Gaming. This your boy Troy back with some more American Truck Simulator here on YouTube. Hope y'all ready to get into this. I haven't streamed in over a week and just been a bit busy with work, holiday season, stuff like that. But I'm back with another live stream here. If you've been playing American Truck Simulator, SCS Software has just released a update of the actual game, and they introduced the Freightliner 2022, right? Cascadia version of the actual truck, which comes with a digital dashboard, digital screen, etc., all that good stuff. And I'm super excited to get this truck. It was in beta for a while, and while it was in beta, I wasn't able to get into the beta because, like I said, I've been working a lot, and I wasn't able to actually get into the actual beta when it was released. But I haven't saw the actual truck myself. I saw other YouTubers actually with the truck in game playing with it, and the truck looks dope, and like I said, it's a Freightliner, and unfortunately here, as you can see, my luck, right? I have not discovered a Freightliner dealership in my game yet, which is my luck, right? Which is just, it wouldn't be me to not have discovered a Freightliner dealership yet. But hopefully during this stream, I'll be able to discover a Freightliner dealership, and we'll be able to check out that 2022 Cascadia. And who knows, I might even buy it, right? Obviously I gotta do some more loads, some more deliveries, because I don't have a lot of money. If you haven't noticed, you guys already know, I have one garage in Spokane, Washington, and I have about four drivers that are driving for me, myself being the fifth driver, and my average daily profit, day-to-day profit, is about $43,000. It could be better. And my most recent driver is Isabel, and you know, she's not that experienced, but I want to give her a shot, get a female in my crew to do some loads for me. And but she's been trying to make some money for me. I'm not gonna trip on it like that, right? She's been kind of doing her thing. You know, she's pretty decent long distance, you know, to be quite honest. On time, you know, she's working her way up there. Let's see her log. She has only done three loads so far. So like I said, she's fairly new. But her most recent load brought in about $5,000. So that's pretty good. That's pretty good. That shows that she has potential to do better. But my guy who has been really doing it for me, has really been Jacob. Jacob has been the dude, has really been busting the ass for me. And he's done a ton of loads at this particular point. I think he was the first driver in my garage that I hired. But overall, we're rounding this thing out, and you know, we're getting better and better. Felipe is my hazmat driver. As you can see, he has the most hazmat experience and hazmat plaques. But I'm trying to get him long distance experience, and I'm actually going to change it back to hazmat cargo because I want him to max out his hazmat you know, attributes, and then work his way down to long distance driving. So that's Jacob. Peter, now Peter is pretty good. Peter is very good with fragile. As you can see, his attributes are maxed out with fragile cargo. He's done quite some loads too as well, so he's been making some money for me too. So also I'm trying to find another garage if I can, and you know, buy another garage so I can obviously expand it, hire more drivers that can make more money for me. And of course, I'm going to buy more DLC because there's parts of the country I still haven't even explored yet. But there are DLCs that I haven't even driven half the map and half the roads yet too. So bear with me. I'll make my way to other states as we go. But where am I at? I don't even think I have a truck. Let me see. Do I even have a truck? Because I think I was pulling freight. Yeah, I don't have a truck. So I was doing freight jobs. I was pulling freight for other people. So let's see if we can get ourselves a quick job. And where do we want to work at though? Oh, wow. Okay, so we got one load going from Tucson, Arizona to Elkhart, Nevada. About 50 grand. And that's not a bad load. It's a long distance. It's gonna take us some time to get there, but that's definitely good money. And if I take this load, this would be the most money that I've made up until this point. But maybe I'll hit some points along the map where I can discover some, truck garages, also maybe a Freightliner dealership. Who the hell knows? But let's take this job, right? It's going to be our first job of the evening. So I'm going to take this propane. We're moving propane, 40,000 pounds. Looks like we're going to be moving in a Mack truck. And it's going to have a sleeper in it. 12 speeds, 415 horsepower, which is pretty good. Pretty decent. Could be better, but it's pretty decent for the load that I'm moving. I can also estimate that looking at the distance, going to be making maybe one stop, in the sense of stopping for gas probably, and probably stopping for sleep along this trip, along this route. So let's get into this. I'm going to take this job. We need the money. We need the dinero, as some may call it. Okay. Okay, so this truck doesn't even have navigation, so they kind of gave me like the basic of the basic. Doesn't have in-dash navigation, so I'm going to need the navigation on the right side of the screen on. That's fine. 3:16 in the morning. Let's check out our load. See what we're working with. Yes, I have no problem with Mack trucks. But we got a long way to go. So let's get going. Let's get this show on the road.
These nuts. Ha! Got him! Ha! Got him!
So we're gonna be moving propane gas, natural gas. Phoenix. 6. This route. Let me just hit the map, and as we leave Tucson, Arizona, and heading up to Washington, let's see what we'll be passing on. Garages that wait, there's a question mark. So anytime you see question marks, that's a good thing. So we get a question mark right here, and this is more likely than not looks like it's gonna be a maybe a dealership, but we're gonna go here anyway. This is a long trip anyway, and I already anticipate I'm gonna have to refuel, so we're gonna stop here, check that out, see what that question mark is there, and so we'll continue to make our way up 93. There's a question mark here. We'll be passing in Elko. Well, then that's when we'll be at the destination, actually. What's over here, though? Anything over here? That's about it. I don't want to go too far off route because I don't want to be too late on delivering this load. Don't mind being late, but I don't want to be disastrously late. Phoenix Freight. Wait, is this a that's a truck dealership. Okay, Kenworth. All right, let's get on the road. Looks like a job. Exit here. So I need to take this exit coming up. Does not seem like they want me to get over on that shoulder. Thank you. Whoa, wrong exit. Excuse me. About to get off on the wrong exit. As it goes to show how many times that really happened in real life. Like, driving and shit. Get off on the wrong exit by accident. Man, this is a beautiful location. SES has done a hell of a job over the years. Big flash sale. Not much traffic this morning, but it is 6:39 on Wednesday morning. Just expecting more traffic. Getting off on this exit here. get up exit 19, Grand Ave, Wickenburg. See where we're at. See where we are at. Okay, so we're coming up on that location real soon where that question mark is at. And I'm real curious to find out what the hell that question mark is. But we're almost there. we are moving along, trying to make our way out of Arizona en route to Washington State.
Bruh.
Gonna have to stop and get my driver some sleep, because he's getting pretty sleepy, it looks like. And I'm gonna need a fuel. Get some fuel in a second. But of course, that was something that I've been anticipating. $4,781. Go, Felipe. Way to go, Felipe. My drivers are starting to produce some real money. That's what I'm talking about, guys. Keep it up. Route, but I'm gonna take this opportunity to get him some rest because he's about to be beat. On the right coming up, Motor City. Looks like a truck stop for trucks to be able to no, that wasn't it. Here it is. This is the rest location for trucks on my right here, which is great. So we're gonna pull in here and fully rested. Now we just need to get some gas because I am running very low on fuel. Let's see where our closest fuel station is, because we're gonna need to fuel up. Well, actually, we're in luck, because where we're going, there's a fuel station there as well. Great. Some fuel. to pay for it. Use time. Actually, but I don't even have the funds to get this truck garage, to be quite honest. $180,000. Better, but you can't afford it. Well, hold on, buddy. It's only $180,000 for this garage. I have $132,000. I can take a loan off of the bank for about $50,000. No, I can't. The loan's active. I can take a borrow. Well, I can borrow $30,000. So actually, I can still get it. Wait, it's $180,000. So if I take another $30,000 out, that'll only be $162,000. So I still wouldn't have enough to buy this garage because it's $180,000. Man. Damn. That sucks. That sucks. That's unfortunate. Well, it's not going to be the only garage I come across, so. So get some fuel and continue along our destination. Get some fuel. Good thing the customer actually pays for the fuel. Don't have to pay nothing out of pocket for fuel when you're running freight for a customer. this guy right here. This Greyhound bus. See where we're at in the world and our destination. So we're moving along pretty fine. Got some ways to go. Looking for any more question marks, but this is a long trip. But then again, it's a lot of money because the payout is real. So, we're doing good though. We're doing good. speeding. Crash violation. Why did I crash? Oh, they're nailing me for everything now. Discovered another small town. Let's see what's in this little town. Not much here in this little town here. Not even a damn gas station. Looks like, well, it is one gas station. I lied. In the rest area, but no garages. All right, but we almost at our destination, which is good. You guys are enjoying the stream. You guys took this entire damn ride with me. So let me get all my tickets. drivers get tired, and hopefully I can make it to the actual destination without needing to actually stop for rest. pull in for a vehicle inspection. Not happy about that. But we gotta do it. £75,000. Kenworth D-Shin. Actually, I discovered a Kenworth D-Shin before. I don't know if this could be a different one. I'm assuming. Yeah, we can put it right there. Urban Nothing Propane. The delivery from Tucson, Arizona to Elko, Washington. Want to thank everybody for rocking out with me here in the LTR Gaming. If you're enjoying the stream, you're enjoying the gameplay videos here on this YouTube channel, why don't you also subscribe to my Twitch channel? LTR Gaming. Everything is in the links and everything is on my main page here on YouTube. Follow all my links. Leave a thumbs up. Catch you guys in the next video. Peace.